Can humans really smell emotions? People affect you. They just do. Is this chemistry or does smell affect us? I suggest both, but more recent studies show that humans can smell emotional states with their noses, even if they may not be conscious of what they are smelling. The human nose, or more specifically the olfactory tract that sends neural signals to the brain and amygdala, is a rapid communication system that affects us far faster than verbal communication. Our human systems have evolved over millions of years phylogenetically to keep us out of danger and safe, and to enable us to build relationships that allow us to thrive. It has been long known and been proven that a baby or child can identify his or her mother by smell alone. Also, men's testosterone levels increase by the smell of an ovulating woman. But now, researchers say that we communicate emotions by chemo signals, that we smell either consciously or unconsciously. Have you ever been in the presence of someone you feel uncomfortable with or unsafe? Well, you are most likely smelling their irritation or anger. Or if you're feeling the need to pull away quickly, you may be feeling their rage. At the same time, when a friend or partner cherishes you, you feel like you want to be with that person more, and upon parting ways, you look forward to seeing them again. So, can we really smell emotions? At Utrecht University in the Netherlands, researchers found that people can smell emotions like fear or disgust through excreted chemical signals. In turn, smelling those chemo signals incites the same sort of emotional response in another. For example, if you smell fear-based chemo signals, you will have an emotional reaction and facial expression indicative of fear. If you feel disgust, you feel this emotional reaction too. Conducted research. A bold researcher at Utrecht University, Gunn Seaman, and his colleagues collected sweat samples from men who viewed either a movie that evoked fear or one that would trigger disgust. After that, female participants were made to do a visual task, all while being exposed to the men's sweat samples, but the men were not even physically present. The female participants who smelled men's sweat gathered while watching scary movies produced fearful expressions and states, while those exposed to sweat produced while watching movies that evoked a disgusted response also experience disgusted expressions and states. The female participants also showed changed behavior in their visual search task as they were exposed to the chemo signals from sweat. They were unsettled. What the research points out. This is a noteworthy finding as it reveals that people don't depend on verbal language, visual cues, or body language to communicate as previously thought. The emotions of the participants were communicated exclusively by chemical signaling, and this affected the participants in the study. Chemo signals are given off from us, and we cannot hide them. They affect others, especially those in the close vicinity of us. We can smell and sense them. This understanding is useful because it means we have to take responsibility for our emotional state as it affects those around us we love. We also need to communicate more honestly if we are nervous, apprehensive, or even fearful about a situation, as our partner, if sensitive, can feel this anyway. There is no doubt that an apprehensive person can make us feel uncomfortable and also activate a fear reaction in other people near him or her that might not have otherwise occurred. But could a furious but silent customer evoke a similar reaction in those around him or her? The answer is yes. But two, it is possible to communicate happy or positive emotions in the same manner as fear and disgust. The answer is yes, too. What this research highlights is our emotional communication. It is real and we have always known it. Now science is growing to validate this. Plenty of research is still needed to be conducted in this field, but this study is noteworthy to highlight our multi-sensory ways of communicating. The reason it is important to know we can smell emotions is because it is important to sincerely connect to one another in the moment and not try to fake it, so human connection is genuine.